students, I welcome you all back to today's session on functional grammar. But before we get going, let me just give you a brief introduction about where you will use the lessons that we are learning today. So if you recall, in the bridge course, we had done a few activities with reference to speaking about oneself, speaking about one's goals, speaking about one's role models, speaking about one's hobbies. For carrying out all these language functions, you will be using simple present tense. So, in today's session, we are going to discuss how to speak about past actions and past habits and present actions and present habits. So, this is the scope of today's lesson. By the end of today's session, I hope you will all become confident about using simple past tense and simple present tense to speak about past and present actions and habits. So let's get going. So when do we use simple tenses? As you know, when we talk about tense, the word tense comes from the Latin etymology, which means time. Tense refers to time, and time refers to the chronology of an action. Action, as you all know, is indicated by the verb in a sentence. So, when do we use simple tenses? Whether it is simple present tense, whether it is simple past tense, or whether it is simple future tense. When do we use this simple tenses? We use simple tenses when we are referring to a particular point of time. Whether it is to talk about past actions, or whether it is to talk about present actions or future actions. Simple refers to a point of time in different time frames. So, look at this line diagram here. So, when we talk about the past, when we talk about the present, that is point of reference, and when we talk about the future. So, simple tenses are used whenever we are talking about a point of time. Let's look at some examples. For example, simple past tense. It is used for an action that happened at a point of time in the past. For example, I ate breakfast this morning. I boarded my bus at 8 a.m. I reached my class by 8:30. These are some of the actions that were completed this morning, and they refer to the chronology of time which happened before this point of reference, that is now. And when do we use simple present tense? It is used when making general statements of truth in the present point of time. Some factual statements or some universal truths can be referred to in simple present tense. For example, I eat breakfast every day. I eat my breakfast at 8 a.m. every day. I wake up at 6 a.m. every morning. I board my bus at 8:30. These are some of the statements which talk about recurring actions, regular actions, and general statements about regular routines. So here we have mentioned it in simple present tense. I eat breakfast every day. I eat my breakfast at 7:30 a.m. every day or 8 a.m. every day. So these are regular actions, part of everyday routine. So here we talk about simple present tense. We use it in simple present tense. Likewise, future simple. When do we use future simple? When we are talking about an action that is going to take place at a point of time or point of reference is in future. For example, I will eat breakfast later. I usually have my breakfast at 8 a.m. but today I will eat my breakfast later, that is at 9 a.m. So used for an action that will happen at a point of time in the future. So here please remember the key word is point of time. Simple tenses are used, the form of simple tense is used when you are referring to a particular point of time. Okay, so that is where you use simple tenses. Now let's look at one more example. Sophie moved to Paris in 2012. So Sophie moved, so this is a past time frame. So Sophie used to live in Paris before 2012. She moved to Paris in 2012. Now Sophie lives in Paris now. She lives in Paris now. We can also say Sophie is living in Paris now, or Sophie lives in Paris now. Both are correct. Then Sophie will live in Paris in future. Now the point of reference is future. So Sophie lives in Paris now. Sophie will live in Paris in future also. Even after 2020, she will live in future in Paris only. So see how I have referred to all the three actions in using simple tenses. Sophie lived in Paris earlier. Sophie lives in Paris now. Sophie will live in Paris in future also. Sophie will live in Paris even in 2021. So these are all referring to points of time when the action is happening. So in such instances, you will use simple tenses. Now, let us look at some more examples. Look at this usage of simple past tense. Can walk to school. So here we are referring simply to the completion of an action in the past. It is a completed action in the past, or it is a state of being. Another sentence we can say is, Ken was a student of George High School. So Ken was a student. What does it mean? That he is no longer a student there. So completed action in the past, or it was a state of being in the past. Ken was a very bright boy in school. We don't know about his college performance. Okay, these are some examples talking about state of being in the past or past completed actions. Now look at the examples in present tense. Ken walks to school every day. So here in this sentence, Ken walks to school every day is the keyword. So every day means there is no variation. It happens regularly. So repeated action is mentioned in simple present tense or state of being. She is a bright girl. She is a very intelligent girl. She is very beautiful. So in all these, we are referring to a state of being. She is very rich. So Ken is smart. Ken is intelligent. Ken is somewhat lazy. In all these sentences, what are we referring to? A state of being. Ken walks to school every day. Repeated action. She wakes up at 4 a.m. every morning. She goes for a walk at 5 a.m. She has her breakfast at 7 a.m. All these are repeated actions, recurring actions. There is no change or variation in the routine. So for such actions, we use simple present tense. Now when do we use simple future tense? Simple future tense is used to refer to an action or a statement of being that will happen in the future. For example, Ken will walk to school tomorrow. Ken usually goes to school by bus, but Ken will walk to school tomorrow. What does it mean? That there is an action that is going to happen tomorrow, because and there is some variation. Ken usually sits in the back of the classroom or sits on the last bench, but today he is on the front bench, or today he will sit on the front bench. Okay, so these are some of the examples to indicate the usage of simple tenses: simple past, simple present, and simple future. Now let us look at the structures one by one. So in present simple, what is the structure like? If it is an affirmative sentence, a positive statement, what do we use? Subject plus verb plus object. For example, I like coffee, you like coffee, or they like coffee. The subject, the verb, and the object. She eats fish, he eats fish. So subject plus verb plus object. This is the structure in the simple present tense. Now look at the negative sentence. So this is a positive sentence or an affirmative sentence. In the negative, how will you write? See, subject plus don't or doesn't plus verb and object. Okay, subject plus don't plus or slash doesn't or verb plus object. Let's look at it. So here we are using the infinitive verb or the bare verb. Okay, you don't study French, he doesn't play tennis. So here look at the usage. Okay, with he and she and it. Okay, second person sorry, third person singular, I have used doesn't. With first person and third person singular and plural, I have used don't. So, I don't study French. He doesn't play tennis. In the negative form or in the, okay, we have seen the affirmative form. In the negative form, this is the structure. Subject, don't slash doesn't plus verb plus object. Okay. Now, let's look at the question, interrogative sentences. How do we use? We use the auxiliary, do or does, plus subject, plus bare infinitive, plus object. Bare infinitive or the verb. Look at this. Do you play football? Does she read books? Does he read books? Okay. So, this is the structure when we use the interrogative sentence or the question statement. Now, let's go to some examples. Before we go to the examples, let us once again recall how we will use the simple present tense. As I already mentioned, simple present tense is used, okay, to express the idea that an action is repeated, that it is a recurring action, okay, it is repeated again and again, so there is no change or variation. For example, the sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west. He gets up at 6 a.m. every morning. So, it is a recurring action, a regular action without any change or variation. So, it is also a habit. It could be a hobby. It could be a daily event that happens frequently. In all these actions, we use the simple present tense. As I was just mentioning in the earlier part of this session, that to talk about oneself, to talk about one's hobbies, to talk about one's routine, to talk about one's role model, we will be using simple present tense. Then, where else do we use simple present tense? To talk about facts or generalizations. For example, the speaker believes that a fact was true before, is true now, and will be true in the future. What kind of facts are we referring to? Scientific truths. For example, water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Oxygen becomes rarer and rarer as you go up the mountain. So, in all these instances, these are scientifically verifiable truths and universal truths. Honey is sweet. It never changes. Whether you are tasting honey in India or in Pakistan, honey is sweet. So, for such statements or generalization, I saw a crow in India, I saw a crow in Pakistan, I saw a crow in Sri Lanka. So, all crows are black. So, I am making a generalization here. For these kind of generalized statements also, we use simple present tense. Then, where else do we use? We use it to refer to schedule events in the near future. Sometimes, we may use simple present tense to talk about planned actions or scheduled events in the future. For instance, the bus leaves tonight at 6 p.m. So, we are talking about a future action, but it is a scheduled action. The Prime Minister opens the new bridge at 8 a.m. tomorrow morning. The Prime Minister hosts the flag at Red Fort. In all these instances, we are talking about actions which are scheduled or which are planned. Okay? When do we board the plane? The party starts at 8 a.m. So, here we are talking about scheduled events in the future. Though we are talking about the future, we are actually using it in present tense. You will normally see newspaper headlines reporting the itinerary and reporting the planned trips of the Prime Minister or the President. You will say the Prime Minister leaves for Spain tomorrow. Tomorrow is a future, refers to a future action. But we are saying Prime Minister leaves for Spain tomorrow because the action is scheduled. So that is why my plane leaves the airport at 6 p.m. So, when I am speaking, I am still at home, but I am talking about a future action. So, scheduled actions or planned actions of the future is also mentioned in using simple present tense. Now, let's look at some example. For habits or routines, I go to the cinema every Saturday. As I already mentioned, I get up at 6 a.m. every morning. I go to the cinema every Saturday. So, we are talking about regular habits or routines. That means going to the cinema is a regular habit. Every weekend, the person has to see or watch a film. And then, General truths, we already discussed. The water boils at 100 degrees centigrade. Honey is sweet. The birds fly in the air. In all these are general truths. Then, permanent situations. That means situations which cannot be changing with the passage of time. For example, they work in a bank. So that means it's not something subject to time. Okay, he is a banker. He works from 8 to 5 p.m. every day. So these are regular situations that are not going to alter depending on the passage of time. So such situations are also discussed in simple present tense. Then describing oneself. How will you describe? We were talking about it earlier. He is smart. She is intelligent. He is very lazy. In all these. So we are talking about talking about one's nationality, one's identity, one's habits. I am lazy, I am intelligent, I am hardworking, I am an Indian, I am a Mexican. In all these sentences, okay, in all these four instances, we use present simple. Now, let's look at some examples. If you had to talk about your day's routine, in functional grammar, we say that you are going to use these structures when you are talking about your everyday functions. For example, what do you do on Monday mornings? Or what do you do during a weekend? How do you normally spend your Sundays? In all these questions, okay, there is a reference to normal or usual or general way of spending one's time. What do you do on Monday morning? When do you study? What do you do after you get up? What do you do on weekends? In all these questions, to answer all these questions, you have to obviously use present simple tense. Look at the one of the answers given here. In the morning, Sam wakes up at 6 a.m. So here is a verb. Sam wakes up at 6 a.m. He takes a shower. He takes a shower. Let's look at the verbs. And gets dressed. Later he has breakfast. He doesn't take the bus. Negative form of the verb. He walks to school. Instead, in the afternoon, Sam does the homework. After that, he watches TV at 5 p.m. and he plays video games with his friends. In the evening, he has dinner with his family, and finally he goes to bed at 10 p.m. So this is the day's routine of Sam. So here, see how one's day's routine is described using simple present tense. So she gets up at 7 a.m. in the morning. She goes to school at 9 a.m. She has classes from 9:30 to 12:30 p.m. Then she has an hour's lunch break when she eats with her friends at the canteen. And afterwards, her classes recommence at 2 p.m. And from 2 to 4:30 p.m., she has labs. 4:30 p.m., she boards the bus and reaches home by 5:30 p.m. She usually goes for a game of tennis at 6 and comes back at 7, has a quick shower, and from 7:30 to 9:30 is usually her study time. 9:30 she has her dinner, catching the evening news, and by 10 she retires to bed. This is her day's routine. So you will use this simple present tense to talk about your routine activities, to talk about regular habits, to talk about hobbies. I usually go for a film during the weekends. I normally spend two to three hours on Sundays in my lovely rose garden. I love gardening. In all these sentences, I am using simple present tense. Now, so we already said that simple present tense is used to talk about one's regular habits. Like I wake up at 6 a.m. every day. I study till 10 p.m. every night. But what about talking about temporary habits? If you're talking about temporary present habits,
we will use present continuous tense. Please keep this in mind. This is the exception. To talk about one's regular habits, you will use simple present tense. But when you're talking about a variation or you're talking about temporary present habits, you will use present continuous. I already gave you some example. I said she usually likes to sit in the first bench, but today she is sitting in the last bench. She usually sits in the first bench because she likes to listen to the lessons attentively. But today she is planning to sit in the on the last bench, or today she is sitting on the last bench. So there is a temporary. She will sit on the last bench for the whole of this week. So we are talking about temporary present habits. She is studying late in the night these days. So these days means it is not a regular action that she does, but only these days. Probably she has exams. That's why she is studying late in the evening. That is not what she normally does. Or she is working hard on her project this semester. Okay, she is working hard this semester. Again, this is a temporary time frame. A temporary present habit can be referred to in present continuous tense. Then, another place where we use the present continuous tense is where we are making some negative statements about somebody's habits or somebody's traits. For example, my mother is always nagging me on my food. So, these are irritating present habits. You are talking about your mother's habits which you don't like. So, there is a tone of disapproval in the way you refer to that habit. I don't like my mother nagging me all the time. So, my mother is always, look at the usage of the word always. Generally, we say that always is used with simple present tense. But here, I am using it to refer to something negative. My mother is always nagging me on my food. She is so forgetful, she is forever losing things. She is so forgetful. So, there is something said in a irritating or in a disapproving tone. And such habits, negative habits, are referred to in present continuous tense. Temporary habits as well as negative habits, negative reference or mentioning about things you don't like can be used with simple, again, sorry. Can be used with present continuous. So please keep this in mind. Then we already discussed habits in the present are normally expressed by simple present tense plus adverb of frequency or an adverb phrase. For example, look at this. I rarely go to a football match nowadays, but I watch football on TV as often as I can. So, look at this. I rarely go. So, rarely here is talking, it is a adverb of frequency. Nowadays is adverb of time. As often as I can is also adverb of time. So, here what have I done? I've referred to habits in the present. I rarely go to football match nowadays or these days. I watch football on TV as often as I can. So, here I have used, the verb is used in simple present tense, but I watch. See, I am using it with adverbs of time, rarely, nowadays, often. Look at the next one. We buy a TV guide every Friday. We go to watch a film every Saturday. In all these sentences, we are referring to the frequency of the action using the adverbs like every. And here, in the earlier one, we have used always. We will discuss that in little more detail in a minute. Then we already talked present continuous. We use it to refer to some annoying habits. Even though they are present habits, if there is something annoying about it, like I said, my mother is always nagging me about my food. So this is an annoying habit. Okay, habits which annoy us or which surprise us or happen more often than usual. When something happens unusual, we refer to such actions in present continuous. As I said, happen more often than usual. For example, she usually sits on the front bench, but today she is sitting at the back. So here, that means there is some deviation from the regular action. In all these instances, we use the present continuous. We have already discussed it. He is always leaving dirty clothes all over the place. I like her because she is always making jokes. There is no annoyance, but there is something unusual, something, some trait, something surprising about her, which you are approving. So it can be used for present continuous to talk about present habits can be used instead of simple present, where there is some disapproval involved or there is something, some surprising action is indicated, or third instance is where something deviates from the normal routine or from the usual routine. In these three instances, we use the present continuous tense. We have already discussed it, but I am just reminding you once again. Now, look at this, some more examples for simple present tense. I hardly ever go out these days. As a rule, I don't. These are negative sentences. As a rule, I don't watch much TV. We can also use tend to structure to talk about present habits. For example, you can use tend to talk about present habits. For example, I tend to stay in during the week. I tend to study late in the evenings rather than in the mornings. I don't tend to read much and I tend not to read much, or I tend not to read much. I don't tend to spend too much time with my friends. I don't tend to work too much on my mathematics. So, I usually keep the difficult subjects for preparation till the last minute. I don't tend to, I tend to. These are used to talk about present habits. Please keep this in mind. You can also use it for negative habits also. I don't trust her. She tends to lie a lot. I don't rely on her. She tends to delay things and never submits her assignments in time. So these kind of things. So even present habits can be used with the structure tend to using simple present tense. You can also use will or want. That is simple future. Want can be expanded into will not. Okay, we can use will and will not even to talk about simple present actions, present actions, like, because it is more emphatic than simple present tense. Let's see how to use it. I will usually listen to some music before I go to bed. So here, see, I have used, even for present habits, I have used will. I won't normally get up before 11 at weekend. I won't. So here, negative form of will not. Condensed form of will not is want. Okay, so here, see, I have used will and will not or want even to talk about present habits because it is more emphatic than simply using simple present tense. For example, I won't normally criticize anyone, but she is someone I am extremely annoyed and angry with, so excuse me for making negative remarks about her. I won't normally criticize anyone. So, I will not normally criticize. Okay? So, you are talking about a negative habit, but here you are using simple future. So, instead of using simple present tense, I am using simple future because I want to add more emphasis, or I am making some exception to what I normally don't do. Then, let us look at the adverbs or the time markers that are used when we are using the sentence in simple present tense or to talk about actions or habits of the present. For example, adverbs of frequency like usually, often, always, never, sometimes, before, and these adverbs are all placed before the main verb. Okay, for example, I can say, I usually come to the class on time. I usually come to the class on time. I often go to see my grandmother during the weekends. I always answer my roll call in the classroom. I never postpone things. I sometimes go out to the canteen for a cup of tea with my friends. Okay, so in all these adverbs are used with actions of the present or present habits or present routines. Okay, present routines, and we use these adverbs in a sentence just before the main verb. For example, I always come to school by car. Okay, he usually eats breakfast at 7 a.m. She rarely cooks. Okay, sometimes I go to party. So in all these are all adverbs of time which go with the simple present tense. Okay, which indicate to you that these actions are happening in the present tense. So in all these, okay, always, often, usually, sometimes, rarely, never, every day, every week, every month, all these, okay, they are placed before the verb. See here how it is placed. I always come to school by car. I come to school by car every day. Okay, I always come to school by car. So here come is the verb, and I have placed the adverb always before the verb come. So when these adverbs are used, usually, sometimes, often, rarely, okay, never, all these adverbs are used before the main verb. Okay, they are placed before the main. You don't say I come always to the school is incorrect, or I come sometimes to the school by bus is incorrect. I sometimes come to school by bus. I always come to school by bus. Okay, so this placement of the adverb before the main verb is very important, and you should not misplace it. Let us look at one example. Every weekday morning, I dash as soon as my alarm dash. So what will you use here? Every weekday morning, I rise as soon as. I rise as soon as my alarm rings. After 10 minutes, I go to the bathroom. I dash my teeth and dash my hair. So what will you use here? I brush my teeth and comb my hair. After my shower, I myself dash with a big towel. What do you do with a big towel? I rub myself, or you can also say I dry myself. Okay, I dry myself with a big towel and go back to the bedroom. So here the verbs are dry, get up, or here I get up, okay, instead of rise. Get up, comb, rings, brush. So all these verbs we have used in simple present tense because we are using them as part of our day's routine. These actions happen one after another, and they are the normal routine. That means there is no variation in this routine. What you do normally, what you do regularly. This is how we use simple present tense. Now, let us look at simple past tense. So now, let's look at past simple. So where do we use the past simple? We usually use it to talk about the completed past actions. For example, she got married last year. She was married in 1987. These are actions which were completed in the past and so belong to the past. Let us look at the structure. The structure is subject. It's not object, sorry. Subject plus verb plus object. I went to the park. I, subject, went to the park last week. So here the time indicator is last week. She decided to do the homework. So when did she decide to do it? Sometime in the past. So these completed actions in the affirmative sense or in the positive statements indicate to you that these actions were performed in the past. Now, when do we use simple past tense? We may use simple past tense to talk about completed actions in the past or what you did in the past, or even to talk about past routines or past habits or past hobbies or interests which you no longer pursue now. Even in such instances also we can use simple past tense. So for example, if someone asks you, what did you do yesterday? How did you spend last weekend? So obviously they are trying to talk about something that you did in a point of time or at the in the past. For example, if somebody asks you a question, what did you do yesterday, whole of yesterday, how will you describe it? You will say, I got up at 6 a.m. I cleaned my house till 7 a.m. Then I started for the college. I waited at the bus till 7:30, and then when the bus did not come, I walked to the college. Since the bus was late in coming, then I attended my classes. After my classes, I played football in the ground with my friends. Came back home, I studied for a couple of hours, and then what did I do? I played some TV games or I played some computer games. After that, I called up my friend and talked to him for about half an hour and then watched TV after my dinner before retiring to bed. So, see how I have strung all these actions together and I have explained my actions performed yesterday. So, if someone says, what did you do last weekend? Well, last weekend, I got up at 8:30. Had a large breakfast, then drove down to the countryside to visit my granny, spent with her a couple of hours, had lunch with her, and then came back to meet my friends at the old club where we regularly meet during weekends. I spent some time with them, then we watched a film in the evening and had dinner at our favorite restaurant. Then I came back home around 9:30. And dropped to bed by 10 p.m. This is how I can explain my time spent in the last weekend. So when you're talking about past routine or when you're talking about past actions, you can use simple past tense. So if you remember, we had earlier spoken about how to talk about present routine. Okay, if somebody asks you, explain your day's routine, you will say, I get up at 6 a.m. I go for a walk from 6 to 6:30, come back home, have a shower, and by 7 I have my breakfast. 7:30 I board the bus to the school, and 8:30 to evening 4 p.m. I attend my classes. After classes, I meet my friends in the football ground, play a game of football with them, back home by 7, and 7 to 9 I usually study, and then by 9, I go for dinner down to the dining room, have dinner over a television with my family. And by 10, I retire to bed. I have explained my current routine all using simple present tense. Just like that, you can explain your past day's routine or past weekend in string the actions together using simple past tense. Now, you can ask questions in the past. You can talk, use interrogative sentences. Where did you go on vacation? So, look at the verbs again. Where did you go on vacation? Suppose I'm talking about present, inquiring about present actions. I will say, what do you normally do during your weekends? How do you spend your evenings at home? What do you do on a rainy day? So, these are questions inquiring about present actions, regular interests. But if I'm talking about past actions, I could say, where did you go on vacation? That is completed. What did you do on the vacation? Who did you see? Which movie did you watch on vacation? Did you like it? Did you meet someone special? Did you study anything? Did you read a magazine? All these questions are related to the vacation time. And how will the person, all these questions are posed in the past tense using the do form of the verb did. So all these questions are in using the auxiliary verb do in the past tense, that is did. Did. The questions are in past tense. Obviously, the answers will be in present tense. Where did you go on vacation last summer? I went to Italy. I went to Paris. What did you do? I watched some carnival going on in the street. I visited the Eiffel Tower. I went to the museum, the great museum in Paris. Okay, what did you do? Who did you see? I met a few French friends with whom I have been pen friends. Which movie did you watch on vacation? Well, I did not watch any movies during the vacation because I don't know French and the local cinema was only playing French films. Did you like it? I did not see any films, so I cannot really tell you whether I liked any film. Did you meet someone special? Yes, I met an elderly old man with whom I became great friends and now I regularly correspond with him using an email. Did you study anything? There was nothing to really study. I just went as a tourist and I visited lot of places. Did you read a magazine? Yes, I read some magazines during my flight from Delhi to Paris. So these are the kind of answers you could give. So all the answers obviously will also be in past tense. Now let's see how to use the past tense. We will try to do a small exercise. Use the correct form of the verb on the lines using the simple past tense. Now let's see. John Lennon. Who was Lennon? Lennon was the famous Beatles singer. Beatles was a musical group of from London. Okay, it was very popular in the late 1970s. So John Lennon was one of the members of that Beatles group. So John Lennon dash born in 1940. So 1940 belongs to the past. So what will be the verb? B form of the verb. What are the B forms of the verb known to you? If you are talking about the present, you will say am, is, are, and so on. If you are talking about the past, what are the B forms of the verb past? Was, were, or the past form of the verb. For example, here B form of the verb, John Lennon, here you will use was born in 1940 in Liverpool, England, where he, what is the past form of grow? Grew up. Simple past. As a teenager, he dash Paul McCartney. So meet becomes met. He met Paul McCartney, who was also another Beatles singer. And they dash to write songs together. They began to write songs together. We are using simple past tense. After several years, they dash a new group called the Beatles. They formed. See how I am using the verbs. They formed a new group called the Beatles with George Harrison and Pete Best. However, Best dash in the group. So what is the verb here? No stay. Didn't stay or did not stay. Didn't stay in the group. He left the group. Bingo Starr joined the group in place of Best. Join. Past form of join is joined. So all are in. So you are referring to a past action. Bingo Starr joined the group in place of Best. In 1964, the group dashed its first hit song, Love Me Do. So see, what is the past tense of perform? Performed. So see, all these are referring to a particular point of time in the past. The action is referred to in 1940 and all the remaining actions are also referring to the past actions. When he started the group, whom he met, who joined the group later, all these are reported in past tense. So you're reporting something. This is a brief biography of John Lennon, who started the Beatles group. But all this happened in the past, so we are using simple past. So to talk about past actions or to report past actions, you will use simple past tense. We usually use it in the history books. Akbar was a great king. He had many tree plantations done. He had many irrigation projects started. He tried to propagate, or he propagated the unity of all religious groups. So these are some of the ways in which we use simple past tense to talk about the past tense. I mean past actions. Now let's look at some more examples. What did you do last Sunday? What did you do last Sunday? What will be the answer to that? I played soccer with my friends. So simple past tense. Where did you play soccer? Look at the question. Where did you play soccer? I played soccer in the park. How long did you stay there? Again, look at the verb. How long did you stay there? We stayed there for about 2 hours. All these actions belong to the past. Did you enjoy the match? Yes, I did. I got so exhausted by the time I finished the match, but I liked it. Okay, liked is also in the past. Did you do something else that day other than playing the soccer? No, I didn't. Well, I just called my girlfriend and went out with her. First he says, no, I didn't. Then he says, I just called my girlfriend and we went out together or went out with her. So see, the questions are asked in the past using simple past, and the answers are also all indicated in the past tense because they are completed actions. So we usually, as I already said, when we talk about actions completed and we are discussing the past actions, completed actions or past habits or what you did in the past, you refer to it as, I watched the evening news. I listened to the radio for a few hours. I ate at a restaurant with my friends last weekend. I visited my grandparents last Sunday. I studied for an exam on Sunday night because Monday morning I have a test. I went to the movies last Sunday. I went to the movies with a couple of my friends. I cleaned your room last Sunday. If you remember, you were out visiting your relatives and I cleaned your room. I took a shower. See, look again, all are in past tense. I played an instrument. I played my guitar. I worked on the computer. All these refer to actions which are done in the past, and so they are all the verbs are used in simple past tense. So this is how we use simple past tense to talk about completed actions or a day's routine in the past or something that you did in the weekend or yesterday. So let us look at some time markers. What are the markers of time in the simple past? One common time frame used is last. What did you do last weekend? How did you spend last Sunday? What did you do last month? All these. So last night, last Sunday, last week, last weekend, last year, last month. These are indicators or time adverbs of time which go with the verb in the past tense. Another indicator is ago. I met him just 10 minutes ago. I met him just now. I met him 10 minutes ago in the canteen. I met him an hour ago in the library. I borrowed a book 3 days ago. A week ago, I ran into him at the market. A month ago, I saw him shopping with his mother. A year ago, he was not so lazy. Now he is very lazy. A year ago, he was very hardworking. So these are the kind of markers we use with simple past tense. Another adverb of time we use with the past tense is yesterday. Yesterday, yesterday morning, afternoon, yesterday evening, the day before yesterday. All these are the expressions of past tense. Previously, earlier, before, in 1940. Or in 1947, all these are indicators of the expressions of the past tense. So, when we talk about the past tense, the most usual way of talking about the habits, past habits, is to use the simple past tense. Okay, and we usually use an adverb of frequency or an adverb phrase indicating the past tense. For instance, past simple, I did it every day for 10 years, but then I gave up. This is a past habit and now I no longer do it. When I was younger, I went running every day. What does it mean? That I'm no longer young and I don't do running every day. I only run twice a week. As a student, she got up every morning. These are all past habits. She got up every morning. I lived in Austria for several years. State. I was very hardworking when I was a student. I am no longer so hardworking. All these are examples to talk about past actions, past habits, or past states of being. So you can also use used to and would. Where do we use used to and where do we use would? Let us discuss it. Used to is used to describe past habits and states. For example, we use used to for something that happened regularly in the past, but it no longer happens now. That means for a past habit or a past discontinued habit, we use it with used to. Okay. And it is something that is no longer. So when you're comparing past habits with present habits, you may use used to for the past habits. You can say, I used to run for 2 miles every morning when I was younger. Now I gave it up, or now I no longer do it. So you're talking about past habits. And when you use used to, there is no need for a time expression. We used last night, ago, yesterday. But when you're using used to itself indicates past tense. So there is no need for another time indicator. So you can use it just, I used to own a horse. I owned a horse once. Okay, that means I no longer own it, but I used to own. So here this used to itself indicates past tense. So no need to use any other adverb of time. Let's look at some more examples. I never used to read much when I was a kid. I used to eat a lot, but I can't afford to these days. Don't say used to in the present. If you are saying used to, you will usually say usually. I usually sit in the front bench. Today I am sitting at the back. You can say I used to sit in the last bench, but nowadays I am sitting in the front bench. So, or I usually sit. When you say present continuous habit, you are referring to a regular and continuous action or habit, you will use usually. But when you're talking about past habits, you can use used to. You can use would for repeated actions in the past. I would normally listen to music for 2 to 3 hours after going home from school. So I would. Would is used for repeated actions or hobbies that you did in the past. I used to go for jogging every morning. Or you can also say, I would go for jogging every morning for 2 to 3 hours. Both are acceptable. When I was in France, I would always eat croissants for breakfast. Okay, I would always. So here I'm using with always. That means you're talking about a past habit or something that you did repeatedly in the past. You can't use would with stative verbs. You can't use, for instance, you can't say he wouldn't have a beard. Okay, you can't use it in the negative form. You can't say, I wouldn't get up early in the mornings back then. I would get up early in the mornings, but you it's not normal to use I wouldn't do something as a regular thing in the past. In the negative form, it is not so commonly used. So now, let's do some exercises. Choose the correct word in the italics. Let's look at this. I didn't use to / wasn't used to like cooking very much. So which is the answer here? Didn't used to or wasn't used to like cooking? So here the verb is like cooking. So which you can say, I didn't used to like cooking. This is incorrect. This sounds little awkward. I didn't used to like cooking very much. That means in the past you didn't like it. I'm getting used to work or working from home. I'm getting used to working from home. This is better. When you have used to, you will have working. Okay. Now, I used to living on my own. I'm used to living on my own is the correct answer. I used to is incorrect. Let's look at the next one. My family /were used to always stay in a caravan for their summer holidays. My family would or were used to, which is better? My family would always. This is better. Would always. Used to is incorrect. Okay. My family would always stay in a caravan for their summer holidays. It's difficult to get used to a different way of life, or it's difficult to getting used to a different way of life. So here, to get. It is difficult to get used to a different way of life. Getting is incorrect. So, I hope that you will, when we give you the handout, you will be able to do all the exercises comfortably with this discussion. Now, in longer text, let us see how it works in the longer text. When I was younger, we used to go swimming every weekend. Every Saturday, we would. Here, see, we is a form, full form is we would. Okay. Every Saturday, we would get up at about 8 o'clock. Then our mom would help us pack our swimming suits and our dad would prepare the breakfast. Okay. So, see, would used to, how it is used. When I was younger, we used to go swimming every weekend. Every Saturday, we would get up at about 8 o'clock. Then our mom would help us pack our swimming suits and our dad would prepare the breakfast. Next one. When I was younger, we used to go swimming every weekend. Every Saturday, we'd get up at 8 o'clock. Then our mom would help us pack our swimming suits and our dad would prepare sandwiches for us. So, there isn't much variation between the two. Okay, both are the same examples. Anyway, so here, just a note how used to and how would is being used here. Okay, this is how you will use it. I hope that this session was useful to you and now you feel comfortable about talking about past habits and present habits, past routines and present routines. Okay, then see you in the next session. Thank you.